Email integration, inbound email integration, where in the request tab, these are the properties of which the email content that is subject to CC, BCC, display name of that particular email and body of the email will get assigned. Body of the email property here, it is available. All these properties on the clipboard will be available on a page called primary page. In this case, the primary page is service page. And now you want to send a response back to them. Let's say the case creation is completed successfully. Then you want to send a response back to the actual sender. Okay, so how to implement that? If that is the requirement, you need to design that in response tab. In the response tab, you can call a when condition. There are OTP when rules available. Look at here. If I open the first when rule, it talks about status of this particular email listener, service email. Service email successfully executed, output status is equal to success. If this property value is success, you can define a message content here. Look at here. You have a message content of HTML stream. So this is HTML rule. So it is not mandatory that your message content should be HTML rule. What are the other types of mappings available here? Clipboard property and a constant or XML stream or correspondence. Which one is better? You can go with HTML or you can go ahead and create a correspondence. Some correspondence. It can be anything. Executed successfully. In the correspondence, you know how to write the correspondent body and all. You write that particular correspondence will be taken as subject of your email. Similarly, you go ahead and add another one, from. So what do you mean by from here?
From email address.
The email from which you wanted to send a notification to the actual sender. So that from email also you can just go ahead and assign it to one of the clipboard property or something, you can set it accordingly. So apart from this, so these are the two values available, right? Apart from this, you can add more when conditions. Again, one more when condition: when mapping error is occurred, otherwise when PY service create work. What is this when rule all about? Create work is equal to true. That means work orbit is successfully created. If work orbit is successfully created, this parameter will be true. If this condition is satisfied, again you can just go ahead and write down the message content. What is the subject and all. Like this, you can go ahead and add multiple conditions here and write down message content for each of the condition. By default, what is the one? That means in case of any situation that happened, what is the generic content that you wanted to go ahead and assign for the message content? It is talking only about subject and from. What about the body? What about signatures? What about two email anyway, we'll be reading that. Two email will be this one, right? This is actually the two email to which you want to send email notification. This and all you should know. Otherwise, you cannot design it. Now, my requirement is whenever there is some situation happened, like if at all it is successful or work output is created successfully or default or is there any mapping error or security error, service error, something like that, I wanted you to define some content here like subject and body. Without using this also we can implement it. So how to implement it is, you can directly open the activity actually which is creating work orbit and all. This is the activity which is responsible, right? After all the steps are successfully completed in this activity, further can I add more steps? After create work from email, once this is executed, I will add one more step. If the status of this step is success, does it mean work orbit is created or not? Success, what I am going to do is I am going to call another activity. I'm going to call another activity here. Call my correspondence activity something. What I have to write in this activity? In this activity, I have to call send email notification and all. I have to accordingly pass the parameters. What are the parameters I have to pass here? To email. Tell me what is the property that I have to use for to email. Which property I have to use for to email? For Yeah, inbound email dot py from. This is what the two email for you while sending email notification. And from email and all, you can read it from the sender information of email account, right? It will take from there directly. Sender information, did we fill in email account? When you open the email account role, look at here. Integration, email, email account. For this specific email listener, we are using this particular email account. In this email account, does it have sender information? We'll take the sender information from there and do email from py inbound email dot py from. That is true. Suppose if you want to include the same CC also, py inbound email dot py CC is there. You can include all those. Apart from this, body of the message and subject of the message. Subject of the message, you can define in response tab. Suppose you do not want to define here. Can you pass it directly or not? From where you can pass it? You can assign the parameters of send email, that activity, OTP activities are there, right? For that, you can pass the parameters of what is the subject and what about other one? Body of the email. For that, you can pass a correspondence, another correspondence. That and all we have already worked on. So it's up to you how you want it to go and design the OTP activity, what you have by default available. You can extend this activity meaningfully to call another activity which is going to send email notifications to the client based on certain status. It can be failure status, it can be, suppose if it is failed, this is the step I want to execute. If it is success, I want to execute another step with a different correspondence in case of failure, in case of success. So in case of failure, if I wanted to go ahead and include the failure message, which property I have to use? There is an OTP property, py message label. You can just go ahead and include that py message label that have error message. If you go to clipboard, you'll see error messages, right? Tracer and all. That property is py message label. Okay. So this is how the design of email listener up to the wizard is very easy. And after that extending, you should have clear cut knowledge about outbound email integration. If you wanted to send a response back to them, you need to include outbound email integration here. Apart from this, decision rules and all, whatever you wanted to call is up to you according to your design. Maybe you wanted to call a table. If the error code status is some different status, based on the status, you want to get the error messages from one of the table. You have to do obj open my handle based on that and get the error messages, include the error message here and then send it in the email. So like this, the rest of the design, we already know, we have knowledge about how to work with that. Combining all the email integrations, tables, obj open, all this is up to you, okay? So like this, you can just make it a complete email integration whenever you wanted to go ahead and send a response back to the actual sender. Okay, but you should know what property we have to use for sender information, sender email.